course CAC324. This lab is based on Windows form creation, which will be used to accept and display information of a student. Let us see the contents of this lab. So at first, we will see what are the prerequisites for performing this lab, objectives of this lab. Then we are going to see some of the basic controls, and at the end, I am going to give you a demonstration which will be used and which will perform your task. So considering that you are having knowledge of classes and objects creation in C# language, we will move further. At the end of this tutorial or a video, you will be introduced with the concept of Windows form. Also, you will get to know some of the common controls and how to use them in Windows applications. Along with this, you will be introduced with how to compile and run your first Windows application by using Visual Studio software. So let us start with some of the basic controls that we are going to see and we are going to use in this lab. So the first one is labels. Now the labels are most frequently used C# controls, and these controls are used to display your text. Now these controls are derived from the base class forms, which is included in namespace system.windows.forms. The next basic control is text box. As you know, text box control is used to display or accept an input from user, whereas the additional functionality which will be provided in Visual Studio is that we can have multi-line text box for multi-line editing and password character masking. Now this password character text box is used for taking password input from user. There are certain properties related to a text box. Some of them are listed over here. Basically, these four are the examples of these properties. So, first one is width, second one is height, third one is back color, and the fourth one is foe color. Now, to access any of the property belonging to text box, you can use a syntax like your text box name dot property name equals to value. So here you can see how we can use these four properties in this slide. Now the next basic control, which is the far and foremost important one, is a button. Whatever you are going to perform in your Windows application, that will be a result of button click. So a button control is an interactive component which enables user to communicate with the application. Now this button click event can be performed by using either entering a mouse or pressing enter key or a space bar. We are going to see how to use these controls in few slides. Now as I have said to you, we are going to perform a click event. So basically, how to access a click event, this is an example of it. So private void button click, we are going to pass two objects to it. First one will be sender and second one is E. The next basic control is radio button. A radio button is a control which enables user to select a single option from group of choices of similar control, whereas the next control is checkbox, which will be used to take input from user, or rather we can say it is used to take multiple inputs from user. So the space the radio button is used to take single input, whereas The checkbox is used to take multiple inputs from the user. Now, as you have cleared with the concept of radio button and checkbox, let us have a reflection on one important question which will make you understand where to use a radio button and where to use a checkbox. So let us reflect on, can you think of example fields where radio button and checkbox can be used? You can take a minute to write down or to think probable answers for it. I hope you have thought of some example of usage of radio button and checkbox. Let us see what I have thought, where radio button can be used and where checkbox can be used. So the first one, while selecting a gender, so gender can be, let us consider male or female. So while selecting a gender, I can use my radio button, whereas while selecting hobbies, I can use checkboxes. Why? Because hobbies can be more than two. A person can have more than two hobbies. So in that case, we can use checkboxes. Whereas while selecting a typical value of gender, we can use radio button. The last control which we are going to see is a combo box. Now basically a combo box is a control which enables user to select items from list. Means suppose there are 2 to 3 values and we have to choose one value among it. So in that case we are going to use a combo box. Now let us demonstrate on how to perform the task of accepting and displaying information of a student. So I am going to illustrate you how this task can be performed with the help of software Visual Studio 2012. To begin with, you have to go to Visual Studio, you have to start it, go to File, New, select Project, under that select any familiar language. Here I am going to select Visual C Sharp and Windows Form Application. Give a good name to this project so that you can remember it for future use. Say Registration Form 1. Let us click on OK. So it will create one simple form named as Form 1, and in Solution Explorer you can view its solution. Now in this form I am going to take some controls from toolbox on the left side. Let us take one label, one text box, one button, let us take some radio buttons. Probably I am going to require two radio buttons over here. Let us rearrange these controls. I am going to give name to this label by going to Properties and change the text as name, whereas I am going to give name to this radio button 1 as male, the second one as female. And I want to display here, instead of button 1, I want to display submit. So I will change that text to and save this. Now I want that on click of the submit button, my data, that is name and my gender, should be displayed on some other form. For this purpose, we will require button click event. So to enable button click event, you can directly double click on this button submit. So it will create a definition of button click event, and here you can access your properties of that particular controls. So let us say text box. Before that, we are going to require some variables. Let us declare them. So public static s1 equals to null. Similarly, s2 equals to null. Since we are going to deal with only two values, I have taken one variable s1, s2, whereas data type for this variable is string. Now I am going to assign value of textbox1 dot text, that is text property of textbox1 to s1, and for s2 we are going to assign, before that let us check if radio button 1 equals to radio button 1 dot checked equals to true. We are going to check whether radio button 1 is true or not. So if it is true, what we are going to do, we are going to assign value of radio button's text. To variable s2, otherwise we will assign value of radio button 2's text to variable s2. Now what I want that whatever value this submit button is going to submit, it should be displayed in some another form. So for that purpose, right click on your solution, go to add Windows form, select a Windows form and give proper name to this form. Let us say display information, display, and click add. So it will create a new form called as display information. So whatever data I'm going to pass, it will be displayed over here. So for this purpose, we can do one thing. Let us stick to labels, and these two labels are going to display my value of name and gender. So how to do that? We are going to display these values on load event of this particular form, that is display information. So before that, we need to create function call of that particular form. So we will create an object of display information over here as display information di equals to new display information, and then what we are going to do, we are going to show this form by using object dot show call. That's it. Whereas to access load event of this form, you need to double click on your form. So just double click on your form, and on double click of this, what I am going to show, label 1 dot text equals to say form 1 dot our first variable, that is s1, whereas label 2 dot text equals to form 1 dot s2. So this is how you can code for your application. Now let us check whether this application works as per expected output or not. So for running your project, click on start. Provide value of name over here. Select gender and click submit. So it is showing you a result. I have entered name as Shivraj Marathe and selected gender as male. So we have obtained our expected output in this particular application. So this is how you can code for your simple Windows application, specifically your first Windows application, to accept and display information of student. You can customize this application with the help of basic controls which we have just learned. You can add combo box over here, you can add check boxes over here. So for the sake of simple demonstration, I have used one text box and two radio boxes serve our purpose. Thank you for watching this video.